Hi everyone, Zindi Tinkham here, and today we are going to talk about communication. Many people think that change management is communication, and communication is change management. Not necessarily. Communication is a very important part of change management, but that's not what change management is all about. There are so many other things that we should do when we are managing change. We have sponsorship, we have metrics, training, we have reinforcement, and many other activities that it's included in the role of a change manager. But today I'm going to focus in communication. I always say that communication is the heart of the change management, because communication is pumping to people all the activities, all the things that they need to know in order to change, in order to transition from point A to point B. You are going to use communication to reinforce your message. You're going to use communication to train your people. You're going to use your communication with your sponsor to share the ins and outs of the change and the vision. So communication is very important. What are some of the best practices that you should know about communication? You have to start with the basics. People need to understand why you are changing, what is changing, what are the risks of not changing, what is in it for them, why should they care? And you should not say that once or twice. Research shows that for somebody to remember something, they need to hear it 7 times. So don't be shy, be creative. Find ways to say the same message several times until your stakeholders are aware. Awareness is the first building block for change. So build your awareness. People need to understand why you are changing. And once you do that, make sure you hear their feedback. People need to feel included. People need to feel that they are heard. Another step when you are implementing change in communication, you have to establish a communication channel where you send your message and you receive their feedback. Unlike some other people, I believe that communication is a two-way street. If I just send a message and I do not ensure that this message was understood, I am not communicating. It's my responsibility as a sender to make sure that the receiver understands the message the way I want him or her to understand. So as you are communicating, make sure it's well received as you expected. Another aspect of effective communication during change is understanding your target audience. Make sure you know exactly who is going to be affected by the change. Some will be affected directly, some will be affected indirectly, but tailor your communication to target these people so they have all the information they need to change. I truly believe that resistance sometimes is just a matter of miscommunication. People are misinformed. People don't know the ins and outs of the change. As you target the right audience and you provide to them all the information that they need, people will change. How you do that? Create a communication plan. Who needs to be communicated? What they need to know? When they were communicated, how these people are being affected, and then you can share with them all the things that's going to happen and they need to be aware. As you deliver your communication and you use the right person, because sometimes there are messages that should be sent through leadership or the sponsors. There are messages that people want to hear through their supervisors, not directly from the communication team. So make sure the sender is the right person, because as you do that, you're not only building awareness, but you are building that desire for change that's going to help you at the end of your process, where people are very open and willing to embrace the change process. So communication is very key. You are going to use communication during your training. Make sure you are providing all the information people need to execute the change. Because sometimes we want to change, but we don't know how. So your communication efforts will help your audience to do that as well. You don't have to be an expert to be a good communicator of a change, you do have to understand what your change is, how people will be affected, and you have to make sure they understand that so they know exactly what to expect and how to implement that change in their workplace. We're gonna be back next time talking about another topic. Thank you for your attention. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.